gospel, Master, it is good for us to be here. And as they were coming down the mountain, he ordered them to tell no one about what they had seen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Today we have a scene on a high mountain, Jesus with Peter, James, and John. And they encounter Moses and Elijah, along the prophets, transfigured, glistening white before them. This is the original, the eponymous mountaintop experience that we all think about and talk about, and we've all experienced in our lives. It was so wonderful that even in their terror, the gospel tells us, and Jesus did not know what to say to them, for they were terrified. Even in their terror, they knew that this was it. Right now is where they wanted to stay, so they didn't know what to say either. And they said, so let's build some houses here so we can stay here forever. One for Moses and one for Elijah, one for Jesus. We'll just stay camped out here, they seem to say. This is great. And then the other two disappeared, and there was only Jesus. As they were coming down the mountain, he ordered them to tell no one what they had seen. And they didn't. Mountaintop experiences in our lives. Let's put aside for a second the hyperbolic visions of this and of the Old Testament lesson, the chariots of fire and the glistening white. That's a whole different sermon. I'm talking about us. Mountaintop experiences in our lives, I believe, come in two varieties, good and bad. Good, moments of great joy, of great happiness, of periods of contentment. And bad, moments of sorrow, pain, periods of frustration. And it feels like in the former, it is good for us to be here, we want to stay here forever. And in the latter, it's no good, but somehow we get stuck in it. The problem is, sometimes we just don't come down from the mountain, and we tell no one. To put this in context, Mark's gospel, as I mentioned last week, is the most concise of the gospels. So much is contained within the first chapter. We've now jumped to chapter 9, mostly because the season after the Epiphany is short this year. Because Ash Wednesday is this Wednesday, and Easter is almost as early as it can be. So we missed a bit in the middle, but we didn't really. It was a lot of teaching and preaching and healing and feeding of 4,000, feeding of 5,000. Jesus was up to business as usual as a Messiah roaming the countryside. And this gospel, as it is in our church here, so it was in the ministry of Christ, was a cardinal moment, that hinge moment, that sometimes even when we physically and emotionally do, we keep being stuck in those, because when nothing's going right in your world, at least you have your pain. At least you have your problem that you can gripe about to yourself and to others. If you've ever been that person, if you've ever encountered that person, if you're anything like me, you've done both. That is not an attractive person to be or to be around. You don't want to be that person. And sometimes you can't help it. So what do we do about it then? What do we do? We do exactly what Jesus told the disciples not to, but which he foreshadowed. Because the Son of Man has come in his resurrected body. He is with us in this body of Christ in which we live and move and have our being. And we are not, as the disciples were admonished, to tell no one our way down from the mountain into a joyous, well-adjusted, wonderful presence is to tell everybody. In your joys and in your sorrows,